الطير أغناها وقد جابت سما كم مرة قد ضقت من عظم البلاء بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب.
So as you can see on screen, it states, it mentions Imam al-Dahabi says, when it became known that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, ارتدت طوائف كثيرة من العرب عن الإسلام ومنعوا الزكاة. Okay? That when it became known that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, the Arabs refused to pay the zakat. Okay? The Arabs refused to pay the zakat. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu went to fight them. And so Umar radiallahu anhu responded to Abu Bakr and said, how can you fight with these people? So Umar protested and said, how can we fight these people although Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu argued with Abu Bakr anhu and he said, كيف تقاتل الناس وقد قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمرت أن أقاتل الناس حتى يقول لا إله إلا الله فمن قالها فقد عصم مني ماله ونفسه إلا بحقه. He said, how can we fight them when Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I have ordered to fight the people till they say none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, and whoever said it, then he will save his life and property from me except on trespassing the law. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu responded, said, by Allah, I will fight those who differentiate between the prayer and the zakat. And he said, and he further goes on to say, he said, فَإِنَّ الزَّكَاةَ حَقُّ الْمَالِ. Zakat is a compulsory right to be taken from the property according to Allah's orders. Then Umar radiallahu anhu said, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا هُوَ إِلَّا أَنْ قَدْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَ أَبِي بَكْرَ رَضِيَ عَنْهُ فَعَرَفْتُ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ. That Umar radiallahu anhu said, by Allah, it was nothing but Allah opened Abu Bakr's chest towards the decision to fight, and I came to know that his decision was right. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu saw consultation, and Umar radiallahu anhu was kind of hesitant at first. So meaning the hadith said, I've been ordered to fight the people until they testify that none has the right to be worshipped, and Muhammad is his messenger. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu fought his case, meaning presented his case well, and then the decision was made to fight those murtaddun min al-Arab, from the Arab. Now, as you can see on screen, you got the chapter Kital Musaylim al-Kaddab, that they fought when the companions fought Musaylim al-Kaddab. Now Musaylim al-Kaddab, for those who don't know, was a man during the lifetime of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam who declared himself to be a prophet. Okay, this man Musaylim al-Kaddab literally means Musaylim the liar. He declared himself to be a prophet, and he even wrote a letter to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam who said, you have a share in this matter and I have a share in this matter. So he was absolutely, and he was a magician as well. So yeah, so Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu sent the Muslims to fight Musaylim al-Kaddam. And as you can see on screen, it states, as Zuhri mentioned, قاتل الخالد مسيلم ومن معه من بني حنيفة, that Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu fought Musaylimah and those with him from Bani Hanifa, who was from the tribe of Bani Hanifa. وَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ أَكْثَرُ الْعَرَبُ عَدَدًا وَأَشَدُّهُ شَوْكًا. And during that time, amongst the Arabs, the majority of the Arabs, he had obviously the strength and the power. فَاسْتُشْهِدْ خَلْقٌ كَثِيرٌ. And many of the companions became martyrs. And Allah defeated Bani Hanifa. وَقُتِلْ مُسَيْلِمَةً. And Musaylim al-Kaddab was killed. وَقَتَلُوهُ وَحْشِيٌ. That Wahshi was the... And Imam al-Dahabi says, وكان يقال قتل وحشي خير أهل الأرض بعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And وحشي killed the best of the people of the earth, meaning he killed Hamza ibn Abd al-Muttalib, meaning Hamza the uncle of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وحشي killed him during the battle of Uhud, and he killed the worst of the people of the earth, meaning Musaylim al-Kaddab. So وحشي obviously avenged and recompensed his crime to a certain extent by killing Musaylim al-Kaddab. And obviously that was sort of a recompense for killing Hamza. Now as you can see on screen, during the Khilafah of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, wafat of Fatima radiallahu anha, that during the reign of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Fatima radiallahu anha passed away. And it states here, وَكَانَتْ أَصْغَرْ مِنَ الزَّيْنَبْ وَرُقَيَّةً. She was younger than Zainab and Ruqayyah. And also you can see on screen, it mentions Fatima radiallahu anha, he says, وَخَلَّفَتْ مِنَ الْأَوْلَادِ, that she left behind from the sons. Who did she leave behind? Al-Hasan wal-Husayn wal-Zaynab wa-Umm Kulthum. And this is Fatima radiallahu anha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her. And regarding Fatima radiallahu anha, we have a narration, as you can see on screen, is narrated by Ibn Abbas that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أفضل النساء الأهل الجنة خديجة بنت خويلد وفاطمة بنت محمد ومريم وآسيا. And this is narrated by Abu Dawood according to Imam al-Dahabi. So he said that the best of the women from of the people of Jannah is Khadija wa Fatima bint Muhammad, the daughter of Muhammad, and Maryam and Asiya. So Maryam was the mother of Isa alayhi salam, and Asiya was the wife of Fir'aun. Now, during the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, a lot of the Huffaz were being martyred in the battles, meaning the Quran was memorized in the chest of the companions radiallahu anhu. So it wasn't in a, or book form wasn't compiled at that moment in time. But because of the huge amount of martyrs from the Qurra, from the Huffaz, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu decided to compile the Quran. So as you can see on screen, he mentions that due to the number of Qurra that were being killed in the Battle of Yamama, he mentioned that due to the killings of the Qurra, meaning the Huffaz of the Quran in the Battle of Yamama, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu ordered for the writing of the Quran and ordered Zayd bin Thabit to undergo this task. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, subhanAllah al-Azim, due to his fear that the Quran could be lost due to the companions that memorized the Quran that were martyred in the Battle of Yamama, he ordered Zayd bin Thabit to compile the Quran, to write the Quran, subhanAllah al-Azim. Now that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu consolidated his rule over Arabia after fighting the Murtadun who refused to pay the zakat, he then ordered the Futuhat to go out, okay, to order the conquest to expand outside the Arabian Peninsula. So as you can see on screen, so he mentions that in the year 13, Abu Bakr anhu, after completing the Hajj, he ordered Amr bin As to Palestine, Yazid bin Abi Sufyan, Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah, and various others to go and carry out the conquest. And there's many other campaigns that he sent out as well, radiallahu anhu, to Syria, etc., etc. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, during his khilafah, laid the foundations for the Futuhat. Laid the foundations for the Futuhat. He sent Usama bin Zayd as well, when that army was sort of instructed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He carried that on, meaning after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed, he fulfilled that mission, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam obviously passed away, wasn't able to send out. Obviously, the preparations were ongoing. So as you can see on screen, he mentions, and then finally he says, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, after ordering many campaigns, he says, وَوَقَتْ الْفِحْلِ, these were campaigns that happened in Dhil Qa'da in the year 13. And after that, he mentions, in this year, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu passed away. And he passed away on the Wathamin Baqeen. He passed away in, and he then ordered the covenant to be passed to Umar radiallahu anhu, and then the khilafah was passed on to Umar. And then he mentions, فَأَوَّلَ مَا فَعَلَ عُمَرْ عَزَلَ خَالِدْ بِنْ وَلِيدْ عَنْ إِمَارَ الْأُمَرَى الشَّامِ. So the first thing that Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu did after he took the khilafah was he basically removed Khalid bin Walid from the leadership of those in the Sham, وَأَمَرَ عَلَيْهِمْ أَبُو عَبَيْدَ بِنْ جَرَّهِ, that he then ordered Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah to obviously take over, وَكَتَبَ إِلَيْهِ بِإِحْدِهِ, and he wrote for people to obviously give him the covenant, ثُمَّ بَعَثَ جَيْشًا مِنَ الْمَدِينَةِ إِلَى الْعِرَاقِ, and then he ordered an army from Medina to Iraq, and then he mentions that ثُمَّ بَعَثَ جَيْشًا مِنَ الْمَدِينَةِ إِلَى الْعِرَاقِ وَأَمَرَ عَلَيْهِمْ أَبُو عُبَيْدَةَ بِنْ مَسْعُودَ الثَّقَفِي وَالِدْ مُخْتَارُ الْكَذَّابِ, and then he sent an army from Medina to Iraq and ordered Abu Ubaidah bin Mas'ud al-Thaqafi, who was the father of the liar Mukhtar al-Kadhab. So he was the father of Mukhtar, who the Shia revere. وَكَانَ أَبُو عُبَيْدٍ مِنْ فُضَلَاءِ الصَّحَابَةِ, but his father was one of the virtuous companions, and he went to Iraq, and this will be explained. So this is just a summarized video of the life of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. As you can see, subhanAllah al-Azim, what a man, what a legend. And as we explained, look at his biography, look at his description, he was a short man, he was slim, but look at the power in the voice, look at the iman that he had. Look at the foundations he laid. He laid the foundations for Islam to spread. And subhanAllah al-Azim, we owe him nothing but gratitude. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him. You won't find a man like Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu ever again. Wallah al-Azim, you will never find a man like Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So that was the first part of my Khulafa'i Rashidin series. The next video will be about Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu. They're just going to be very, very brief and summarized. But it's upon you now to go learn about him even more. To go to his life prior to his leadership, and look how he gave izzah to Islam, and how he supported Islam, and how he was always the right-hand man of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Learn about him and understand that this noble companion, wallah al-azim, he gave so much sacrifice for the deen, and we owe him so much gratitude, and it's best that we repay him by learning about him, that we gain a connection to this man to understand how much he contributed to Islam. So please do that. now that you've got a little understanding of, short understanding of his biography, meaning post Khilafah. So let's learn about him even more. Let's gain a connection to him and gain a connection with the companions. So when we hear their names, we feel some sort of, you know, we increases our love for them. And this is important because the best after the prophets were the companions, regardless what the Shia say. Okay, regardless what the Shia say, the best of people after the prophets were the companions. The Christians say the best after Jesus was his companions, with the exception of Judas. And the Jews say, after Moses and Harun, or Musa and Harun, the best of the people were the disciples and the companions of Moses and Harun. But yet we have the Rafidah who say the people who were with the Prophet ﷺ. So the Prophet ﷺ has, astaghfirullah, had a bad character code where he had companions who were betrayers, who were, you know, usurpers. You know, by their nature, they were treacherous. So the Prophet ﷺ, you know, accompanied these individuals throughout his 23 years of prophethood during the hard times during the hard times pre-migration when they suffered during the boycott, etc. The Prophet ﷺ accompanied the best of people and they lived and honored his message by spreading it. And it was down to them that you have the Quran today. If it wasn't for them, if it wasn't for the worry of Abu Bakr Anhu when the people of Yamama or the martyrs of Yamama were getting killed, he was the one that preserved the Quran. So the Quran you have today, you have to thank the companions for it. So let's not fall into the traps of, yeah, we're not saying they're infallible. Let's get that right there. We're not saying they're infallible. They made mistakes. If you find a mistake from a companion, we'll say, yeah, they made mistakes. May Allah forgive them. Like Allah says in the Quran, قَدْ عَافُ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ, after Uhud, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them for Uhud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared this testimony for them. So what's your problem? But that's, I don't want to get to that. I just wanted to make that clear. The companions are the best of the people after the Anbiya. May Allah honor the companions radiallahu anhum. May Allah be pleased with the companions radiallahu anhum. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise their ranks and allow us to understand their biography so we can increase our love. Take care of yourself. Wait till the next video, inshallah. Umar ibn Khattab is next. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad.
Wahdi saburan musta'inan bis salah. Kam marati عصف الأنين بداخلي كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنته وكم كرهت مصابها لكن رأيت الخير يسكب في أنا كم مرة قد ضقت من عظم البلاء بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب ضحى وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي